wishing you the happiest holiday season from all of us at BCTV.
Give me the lamp, you son of a she-camel!
But it's all dirty and beaten up. It can't be worth much.
I want that lamp!
A magic lamp. A young boy named Aladdin, a beautiful genie, and a scheming villain named Abenazer. Now, if all this sounds familiar, look out, because this is Aladdin like you've never seen him before.
Grab your coat and get your hat.
He sings, he dances, and he dresses like a million bucks. But wait till you meet his mother.
It's an American dress. One yank and it's off.
The way she dresses, it may be Flora McDonald trying to make a comeback.
Then there's the evil Abenazer, who really knows how to handle a crowd.
Shut up!
And a genie with a short fuse.
Don't push your luck, oh master.
And if you like ballet, here's one you'll never forget. Karen Kain is the beautiful Scheherazade. Russ Petty is the evil Abenazer. Jeff Hyslop is Aladdin. And Bruno Gerussi is his mother, the Widow Twanky.
I'll have you know that I've got the body of a young girl.
Well, give it back. You're making it all wrinkled.
The Magic of Aladdin, tonight on CTV.
March 31st, Rob Boyd will ski Whistler for money. Maybe your money. In the Fuji downhill dash for cash. There's $1 million in cash and prizes, including a Saab 900 Sport. See what Rob Boyd can grab for you in the Fuji downhill dash for cash.
It's going to be a lot easier on snow.
Get details wherever you buy Fuji film or Fuji cameras.
Grab the excitement!
Great news from Sears, presenting the star of our show. Our best Kenmore mid-size microwave at $80 off, now $299.99. Give the gift of cooking convenience with this week's great news from Sears.
You got 50,000 on Double Dragon?
Brent Savage has a plan.
He's headed for the video championship.
It's going to take a lot of talent.
Ready? Here we come!
A little romance.
I am not kissing a boy.
And the wizard.
Video Armageddon.
You can do it! You're the best!
Greg Savage in The Wizard. Free Nintendo Pocket Power magazine with admission while supplies last.
Starts Friday, December 15th at theaters everywhere. Consult your local listings.
Life may be getting more complicated, but I'm not. I thrive on simple things. That's what I've always liked about Ivory. Ivory's pure soap, without all the extras. So it cleans my face in a gentle, natural way that just feels healthy.
No other soap is this pure. So pure, it gently cleans a baby's skin. No wonder more women trust their skin to Ivory than to anything else.
Ivory's good for my skin. Why make it more complicated than that?
Give her time to remember how it feels to be tender and to shake her world of weariness.
New General Foods International Coffee's Cafe Peach Cream Flavor Instant Coffee Mix.
With a cup of tenderness.
Bedtime isn't always dream time, but all it takes is a little magic. The Disney magic in the Dreamtime Carousel. At bedtime, different musical moving picture shows. Mickey, Donald, Goofy, and Minnie. Dreaming the night away with the Disney magic you can trust. The Disney Dreamtime Carousel from Mattel. With the quality of Mattel and the magic of Disney, imagination at its best.
John Elias, condition, headache.
Someone has put something around my head like a band, and it's tightening.
Clinical studies prove Tylenol has the strength to deliver effective relief. How do you feel?
The headache is totally gone right now. I feel very good. Good results, good product, Tylenol.
Once upon a time, in a far-off city called Baghdad, lived a young boy so poor he was begging in the streets. This was before free trade.
Alms for the love of Allah. Good citizens of Baghdad, take pity on this poor wretch. I beseech the alms for the love of Allah.
This is where I come in, on my way to the palace to marry the Caliph of Baghdad. Ancient custom dictates that the groom must be the first to look upon my face. The young boy broke this rule.
Her face. I saw her face.
Her face? You saw her face?
He has looked upon the face of the Caliph's bride before the Caliph has.
He must be taken to the palace.
To the vizier.
In the palace, my fiancé, the Caliph, excitedly awaits my arrival. When Abanazar, the vizier of Baghdad, enters. A powerful man who buys his clothes at garage sales.
Am I to be allowed no excitement? Is there nothing to divert me from the boredom of this life? And this is supposed to be the day of days.
And you are the fool of fools.
What was that?
I said, you are the jewel of jewels, sire. It is difficult to see the perfection in things when one is perfection itself.
Oh, I suppose you're right. You always are. When is the marriage to take place?
At sunset, oh, magnificence. Your bride-to-be, Scheherazade, has already passed through the gates of the city. She makes her way here, eager to meet her beloved.
What is she like, Vizier?
A beauty, sire. And by all accounts, she possesses that extremely rare quality in a woman, intelligence.
She has a head on her shoulders?
For the moment.
Yes, I forgot she's to be mine for only 24 hours. Can't this one last a little bit longer?
It is the law, O highest of high, laid down by your ancestors. The king shall not keep a wife for more than one day and one night.
Well, that's a stupid law. How am I to have children? Who's to rule when I'm dead?
Oh, I'll think of someone.
Finally, I arrive. Stylishly late, to strut my stuff for the Caliph and to make sparkling conversation.
Contrary to popular belief, the Earth is round, and we are the only planet that is known to contain life.
Thank you, David Suzuki.
But my lecture was interrupted by the arrest of the young beggar.
Majesty, spare my life. I have done no wrong.
He was caught begging on this day of days, sire.
At the very gates of the city.
I beg for a living, sir. I live from hand to mouth, I and my widowed mother.
Enough!
Lady, I beseech.
The young boy came to me and begged for my help. I love it when people do that.
Take him away and execute him. No, wait! I have a better idea. We are in need of a little diversion. So, execute him here!
My lord seeks diversion, then I shall undertake to entertain him.
How?
By stimulating a force that is stronger than any man, stronger than any magic.
There is no such power. What is this force? Where does it come from?
It comes from within. It is called imagination.
Imagination. Nursery tricks, rhymes and riddles, stories and songs.
They are the foundations on which man builds his world. The magic of imagination.
Magic? I will show you real magic.
You start to show your true colors, Vizier.
Yes, and this is just the beginning.
Your ideas intrigue me, Scheherazade. Tell us more of this magic called imagination.
But, sire, you must wait and...
Silence! Begin.
The realms of imagination are vast and mysterious. There are 1,001 tales hidden in every thought, 1,001 songs.
I knew I was cooking, so I decided to tell them a magical story that would take them on a long journey of unforgettable adventure and big, big laughs.
Once upon a time, in far-off China, in the city of Peking, there lived a boy. His name was Aladdin, and he lived alone with his widowed mother, who worked hard in her laundry to keep them both. But they were very poor, and often Aladdin was forced to beg in the streets to make the money to pay for food and other things. He was a fine boy, not too bold, not too handsome, and he had many talents, the greatest of which was speed. He could outrun his pursuers and change his mind as quick as the leap of a startled cat.
That's me.
But stealing apples, tricking the emperor's guards, and playing the devil in his mother's laundry were nothing compared to the adventure he was about to embark on.
Adventure?
To find the most powerful object in the entire universe.
And what is that?
The great lamp of Solomon. Whoever possesses it holds the power of the gods. The lamp will deny its owner nothing.
Where is this lamp?
It lies within the cave of a thousand sides.
Where is this cave?
Vizier, this is just a story.
Is it? I'm not so sure. How does one get there? How do I find the cave?
By using your imagination, Vizier. Your imagination.
Right, settle down, settle down. Enough of this frivolity.
We seek the boy Aladdin.
Why? What's he done?
He's been stealing apples from the princess's orchard.
He's been climbing over her wall and pinching her Bramleys.
The swine?
He's been purloining her Granny Smiths.
The rotter?
He's been nibbling her golden delicious.
The lucky devil.
Hey! Has anybody seen this outlaw? This public enemy number one.
It's for his mother, the Widow Twankey.
Right, that's it. We seek the whereabouts of the Widow Twankey.
Away, give it a biscuit. The Sally Ann. I got it for a ridiculous figure. It's an American dress. One yank and it's off. Could I have an arpeggio, please, Ben? Isn't that a lovely arpeggio? I've had such a busy day. I've been shopping at the bay. And I didn't spare a dollar or a dime. And to plan a little scam, I had lunch with Van der Zandt. Which seemed like a good idea at the time. And if I didn't have a shopping list, I don't know what I'd do. And thank Confucius that I had it written down. And though you may deem it trivia, I've got 15 jars of Nivea, just in case I fancy slipping out of town. When I fly into Dubai, all the people shout and cry, Twanky, Twanky, don't put the wind up me. When I breeze to the cheese, they all hold their nose and sneeze, Twanky, Twanky, don't put the wind up me. I'm quick, I'm slippery quick as the eel within its jelly. I'm a Chinese wok and a hiney sock, belly, belly, smelly. When you see this old gal, I don't mind if you all yell, Twanky, Twanky, don't put the wind up me. Oh. National Ballet of Canada. I'm slippery quick as the eel within its jelly. I've a Chinese wok and a hiney sock that's belly, belly, smelly. When you see this old gal, I don't mind if you all yell, Twanky, Twanky. Boys and girls, mummies and daddies, my name is Widow Twankey, and I'm Aladdin's mother. And I've had a terrible day at the shops. My American Express card left home without me. I popped into the beauty parlor. I said to the girl, my hips and thighs are all wobbly. Never mind, she said, your stomach covers them. The doctor was no better. Doctor, doctor, I said, every time I look in the mirror, I throw up. What's wrong? I don't know, he said, but your eyesight's fine. I slept in this morning. I missed the garbage truck. I chased it down the street. I hollered, driver, driver, am I too late? Oh, no, he said, just jump on. Does anybody want a fresh egg? Laid this morning, the egg that is. Here you are. What? Don't all scramble for it.
There we are.
Where?
There.
Oh, thank goodness. I was wondering where I was all day.
Are you the mother of one Aladdin?
At last count, yes, there was one. But why are you inquiring after my only offspring, pray?
We wish to take down his particulars.
Take down his particulars? It's a bit chilly for that sort of thing. What's he been up to now?
He's been climbing over the wall of the princess's garden and handling her cookers.
Handling her cookers? Oh, the sauce. I wonder what's come over him.
Well, when we catch him, we're going to take his legs and throw them over there.
Oh, I say.
Then I'm going to take his arms and throw them over there.
Oh, I say.
Then I'm going to take his head and throw it over there.
Oh, I say.
What do you say to that?
That's Aladdin all over.
This criminal must be apprehended at all costs. Do you realize you are the mother of a miscreant, the harbinger of a hoodlum, the cohort of a coward? We will have him, madam. Oh, yes, we will have him.
Sooner or later, he will give himself away and...
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, not at all.
In the clink, Buffalo police brutality, here comes the judge. The truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth. 6 years out on parole, criminal record, can't get a job, end up in politics.
Do you want that to happen to your son?
Oh.
Far better that he follow in our footsteps and become pillars of society. Do not forget, if you want to know the time, buy a wristwatch.
Yeah, what was all that about?
Oh, nothing, Mom. They've mistaken me for somebody else.
Now, don't you go misbehaving. We're in enough trouble as it is.
Oh, don't worry, Mom. Soon all our troubles will be over. I've got a feeling that a miracle is about to happen. Something stupendous. Something impossible.
Pat Carney's going to play goal for the Vancouver Canucks.
No, don't be silly. Whatever it is, it'll change our life.
The only thing that'll change our life is if you get yourself a job. Oh, Aladdin, Aladdin, you're a dreamer and a wastrel. To think that a son of mine is being sought by the police, my own flesh and Guinness. Well, I can't be standing around here all day. I've got bloomers to boil and socks to soak. If anybody comes looking for me, I'll be in the kitchen polishing the wok with the cat's bum.
You know, I just know that today's special. I can feel it in my bones. I've got a plan, but I'm going to need some help. You see, I'm in love with the princess, but there's one problem. She doesn't know it yet. The other problem is that, well, no one is allowed to look upon her face on pain of death. I've just got to get to talk to her, though, just for a minute or so. So, will you help me?
Yeah!
Yeah? Okay. Because, see, I need confidence. Yeah. I need encouragement. I need trumpets. Yeah. Well, thank you. That was nice. I need drums. That was even better. I need a whole orchestra.
Blow the bugle, sound the cymbal. All my troubles fill a thimble. I'm as happy as it's legal to be. Come on, kids, let's hear it for me. Sound the tom-tom, start it drumming. Cue the chorus, keep them humming, cause I'm climbing up the limb of that tree. Come on, kids, let's hear it for me. Cause that overwhelming sensation, I could stand for a standing ovation. Give my entrance cue to the band, and I give this little fella a great big hand.
performance is a sellout. The critics and the public agree. I'm the number one attraction to see. So applaud it and cheer it. Come on now, let's hear it for me. Woo! Hi. Inside me, I'm free. They've been banished by a royal decree. And your head feels so good when you finally clear it. If I saw a worry, I wouldn't go near it. Come on now. Come on, kids. Let's hear it. Let's hear it for me.
Is the hero of your story, a poor man's Leonard Cohen.
When will he find the lamp?
He is yet to hear of it, let alone find it.
He knows not of the lamp's existence?
Not yet.
Then there is still time.
Time for what?
Time for me to take over this story and control the outcome.
Why would you do that?
Because I want that lamp!
Your lust for power is decidedly unattractive, Vizier.
Oh, shut up, you miserable little monarch!
Vizier!
I will be your wet nurse no longer, you buffoon! For years I have suffered your whining stupidity, but now I have the power within my grasp to change all that.
But this is all in your imagination, Vizier.
Is that so, my lord? This woman holds more witchcraft than she admits to. If this is all imagination, then imagine this! You said that only one with a stronger imagination can take over this story. Well, I have just imagined him out of existence. Now I will do the same to you. Except, I feel you could be useful to me in the future. I have toad and tail of newt, myrtle leaf and hemlock roots, maw of mole and claw of dog, skin of snake and spawn of frog. By lion's breath and viper's sting, entrap this maid within this ring. Within the ring of Samarkand, only to appear at my command. Scheherazade, once proud and brave, has now become the vizier's slave.
Abenazar has me wrapped around his finger. Call the police or have a back scratch, whatever. Just don't miss the rest of the story.
Okay, now remember. We want parents to call Kraft macaroni and cheese, Kraft cheese and macaroni.
Annie, this isn't going to be easy.
Just tell them the cheese should come first, because it's the cheese sauce that makes it taste so good.
Kraft dinner, made with real Kraft cheddar.
Let's just say we explain everything over and over, and they still won't call it Kraft cheese and macaroni.
Then what? Tell them to clean up your room.
Kraft dinner, the cheesiest tasting, and a good source of protein.
Some clothes you want to look as if they've been washed a million times. Others, you want to look as if you've just bought them. Then why trust them both to the same heavy-duty detergent? Because if it's tough on one, it can't be gentle on the other. Trust Zero, the gentle one. Just for the things you want to keep looking new. Zero.
In your lifetime, this happens so rarely. This, however, will happen just once. Toyota's 25th anniversary.
anniversary in Canada. And in celebration, the limited edition Corolla, Camry, and Tercel. Distinctive, specially equipped, built in very limited numbers. And like the Eclipse, here, then gone.
This year, you can bring someone special home for Christmas. McDonald's presents Muppet Babies. Baby Kermit, Baby Fozzie Bear, and Baby Miss Piggy. A different one every week while supplies last. $2.69 each, and with every purchase, you're donating 50 cents to Ronald McDonald Children's Charities. Muppet Baby plush toys for a limited time at participating McDonald's.
Good time, great taste of McDonald's.
Fisher-Price announces the opening of a brand new McDonald's.
I'm cooking. Look at me, flipping. Mama, can't you see it frying? Baby, you and me, shaking and serving too. I'm driving. Yes, we're taking orders. I'm a sight to see. I'm cooking. Yes, really me. Look at me, Fisher Price can do.
Introducing the fun with food McDonald's. It gets little imaginations working fast. Food and restaurants sold separately.
Look at me, Fisher Price can do.
Well, God bless America.
Oh, that's something to be proud of.
I haven't slept.
That's the way it goes.
God, would I love to throw a hammer through a plate glass window.
Can we come to some sort of conclusion here?
Okay, you want a conclusion? I'll give you a conclusion.
BCTV's Roseanne. Catch her in action Tuesday nights.
There's nobody here.
Well, I should jolly well hope not.
Today, for some reason, I was rather expecting a demonstration.
They wouldn't dare, oh light of the world.
Rather a pity in a way. I could rather look forward to a good clutch of executions.
Well, do not abandon all hope, your hugeness. You still have a few more streets to pass through.
Yes, we do, don't we? Very well. Lead on, Pong! Lead on!
Now, don't forget you're supposed to have run over me by accident, and you're in a state about it.
I still think it's a stupid idea and a dangerous one to boot. What if the princess's procession doesn't stop processing?
It will. It's a pushover.
It'll be a walkover if it doesn't stop. It'll be you who's walked over.
Princess, terrible accident.
What happened?
Me pushy garbage down street and clash me run over coolie.
Terrible. Hey, you two, cut it with a bad accent down there. Put this thing down, you scallywags. Gently, for God's sake. What do you think this is, the ice capades? You could have broken something important. Now, what's going on? It's you, the kid from the apple tree.
And you're the princess. Small world, isn't it?
Well, it is from up here. Now, what's going on here?
Oh, please forgive me, princess, but I just had to meet you, and I couldn't think of any other way.
Well, it beats the home shopping club. Are you hurt?
Well, I shall be if you refuse to talk with me.
Beat it! You may retire.
Well, that's very kind of you. I was going to wait until I was 65.
Okay, kid, shoot.
Well, princess, I've seen you in your garden, and
Well, you just seem so kind and so gentle and so tall.
Yeah, it's great, isn't it?
Well, I just thought it was unfair of the Emperor to keep you hidden away like that. I think you're as much a prisoner of your life as I am of mine.
Well, Faye, that's cute. And so are you. What's your name?
Aladdin.
Are you sure it isn't Robert Redford?
No.
Oh, well, beggars can't be choosers. What do you do?
Well, I'm a nobody.
Oh, come on. Nobody's a nobody.
You know, I just knew you'd be nice. Ever since I saw you from the apple tree.
Oh, yeah, you sit up there a lot, don't you?
Yeah. I sit up there and I dream that someday maybe I'd become somebody very rich, with a grand title, a prince, perhaps. But, well, that's impossible.
Well, if you became this prince, what would you do?
Well, I would ask you to...
What's this? A young boy on the streets and in the arms of my daughter. My daughter! He has looked upon the face of my daughter.
Well, I'm sorry, sir. It was an accident.
And now he's looking at me.
Oh, come on, Pops. It wasn't his fault. It really was an accident.
Accident? You may go. I will give him accident guards. Seize him.
You take your hands off my baby, you hooligans!
Silence, woman! Where are my police?
Don't you lay a hand on me! Not unless you mean it! And who do you think you are standing there beside yourself? And what a horrible couple he makes!
You are who?
No, I'm not who lives next door. I'm the Widow Twankey, the best laundress in Pekin. Sock soaker and singlet ringer to His Imperial Majesty, the Emperor, easy on the starch, of China. You are who?
I am the Emperor of China.
Did you hear what he said? That's a good one, that is. He says he's the Emperor of China. Oh, my God, it is him, isn't it? That's what I thought. Oh, you're majestical. Oh, you're Brian Mulroney ship. My poor boy Aladdin, I don't know what he did, but he didn't mean any harm. He wouldn't hurt anybody. Spare him! Spare him!
Spare him! Do you realize, a woman, that this commoner has had the effrontery to gaze upon the face of the princess? To look even at me? He had no business being on the street at all. Come to that, neither have you. What? Come to that? Neither has that little girl. What are you doing here? Don't look at your mummy. She shouldn't be here either. God sees them all. Arrest everybody.
I'm warning you. You keep that up. I'll cancel the upcoming Christmas holidays and send you right back to school. That goes for the children, too. Hey, how about that emperor, eh? I haven't seen a performance like that since Leonard Nimoy starred in The Life Story of Yoko Ono. So, a quiet street, no one in sight. Now to set my plans in motion. But first, I need information. Information that only one person can supply.
Your wish is my command, O Master.
Oh, say it again.
Your wish is my command, O Master.
Oh, just once more.
Don't push your luck, O Master.
Tell me, O refugee from the Nutcracker. I find the cave of a thousand sighs, in which there lies a certain lamp.
3 leagues into the eye of the rising sun, there in the mountains of Buddha lies the cave of a thousand sighs.
Can you take me there?
That I can, Master, but it would avail you not.
Avail me not? Why?
First you must seek the one named Aladdin.
I have no need of him now. All I seek is the lamp.
For you to enter the cave would mean certain death. Only the one named Aladdin can enter and deliver the lamp into mortal hands.
Then by Trini Lopez, so he shall. Begone! Now to seek the boy. Excuse me, you meandering, whistling, tap-dancing one.
Who, me?
Yes, you, a terrific Chinaman. What street is this?
This is the street of a thousand,
Yes?
A thousand, ridiculous.
I shall inquire of this other similarly attired buffoon. Excuse me, oh similarly attired buffoon. What street is this?
Oh, this is the street of a thousand islands,
a thousand Dalmatians. This is ridiculous. All I seek is the one named Aladdin.
You've seen him?
Well, of course I haven't seen him. I wouldn't be asking you if I had seen him.
Seen who?
Aladdin!
Where?
This is interminable. I seek the boy Aladdin for personal reasons.
Assholes!
I beg your pardon?
Assholes! This is the street of a thousand assholes.
Assholes!
You stupid people! All I seek is the whereabouts of the one named Aladdin.
Well, his mother runs a laundry in the middle of the high street.
Well, it isn't exactly in the middle of the high street. Otherwise, the washing would get covered in dirt and mud and tire tracks.
Hey!
Oh, you keep doing that, I'll grow up silly.
Hey! Who are you?
Who am I? My name is Abenazar. I am a magician. I feel the power of the lamp already. Somewhere out there is my destiny waiting for me to possess it. So, Aladdin is the son of a high street laundress, eh? I must seek him out. And when I found him, he shall lead me to the lamp. And when I have the lamp, I shall be master of the world. I will.
There's nothing like a soliloquy to find out about a person. Abenazar is going to trick Aladdin into entering the Cave of Sighs and getting him the lamp. And he seemed like such a nice guy backstage.
Dad, a blade razor with a motor?
Yes, Tori, the Remington Electroblade. Vibrating twin blades feel like they're massaging your whiskers away or your money back.
Keep the money. I'll keep the Electroblade.
Razor-sharp kid, eh? The Remington Electroblade.
Excuse me.
Oh, sorry. I didn't hear you come in. What can I get you?
Some hot cocoa. All by yourself tonight, eh?
Yeah. Well, I let everyone go home early, being Christmas Eve and all.
That was nice of you.
Say, anyone ever tell you you look like... Well, how have I been this year? Naughty or nice?
You really want to know?
Nah.
So, how much do I owe you?
Tonight, it's on the house.
Gift. This year, the Wilshire three-piece self-sharpening knife set is $34.99. Six-piece knife set with block, $79.99. Come home for Christmas.
Of Always Plus add a new dimension, wrapping around the sides to give you far more panty protection, even overnight. The wings of Always Plus, a whole new dimension.
What's the best reason for buying a new Canon copier? Frankly, the answer is blowing in the wind. You see, Canon, is giving $1,000 to everyone who trades in their copier when they buy or lease selected mid-volume copiers. But the trade winds won't be blowing for long, so make sure you act fast before our $1,000 windfall runs out of wind.
Corning's see-through vision saucepan withstands heat that turns ordinary saucepans into sauce. Best of all, it lets you see your meal before it's all over. Visions by Corning. It's a visibly superior gift.
Did you know that there's one day each year that something magical happens?
I'm going to the teddy bear's picnic.
It's a festive celebration for teddy bears only. The Teddy Bear's Picnic, a CTV children's special, tomorrow for the child in all of us.
Drawers. She pulled the string to make it sing, and down came Santa Claus. Ah! What a pleasing posture! Have I the honor of addressing Widow Twankey face to face? Oh, look! It's the Phantom of the Opera. He thinks it's Halloween. If you've come about a payment on the washer, you'll be lucky.
No. Allow me to introduce myself. The name is Abenazar. I have gone to great lengths, dear lady, to find you. I've come all the way from a distant land. Why, do you not recognize me? Your long-lost husband's long-lost brother?
My long-lost husband never had a long-lost brother.
Oklahoma, where the wind comes sweeping down the plains,
will you stop it?
Do you recognize me now?
Well, the hairdo does look vaguely familiar. On the other hand...
On the other hand, you were saying,
dear lady? Well, it must have been the face fuzz that foxed me at first. How delightful to see you again, Mr. Abacadabra.
Abenazar.
Gesundheit. Welcome to my humble home. If you have some dirty laundry...
No, but how gracious of you. By the way, dear lady, I believe you have a son whose name escapes me for the moment.
Aladdin?
Aladdin, yes. Yes, by all accounts, a fine, hard-working boy.
Oh, you're jesting, of course.
Ambitious, too, they tell me.
Ambitious? Oh, yes. He's only going to make himself a fortune and marry a princess.
Really? Well, now, that's very interesting.
Hello, Mom. Is this the boy? Oh, this is Aladdin, all right. Oh, Aladdin, I have a surprise for you. I'd like you to meet your long-lost uncle, Abba Gardner.
Abenazar.
Gesundheit.
Abenazar!
Oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear, oh, dear, that is a terrible cold you have there.
Oklahoma, where the wind comes sweeping down the plain.
Will you stop it?
It is a name, boy, which in my own country betokens power and riches.
Well, fancy that. Well, given a push or two, I might fancy that. Oh, but forgive me. My excitement, I'm forgetting me manners. All the way from a distant land, you say. Well, you must be thirsty. I'll just pop down to the pub, the Pig and Whistle, buy a bottle of the necessary. We'll have a wee drinky to celebrate. The Widow Twankey exits briskly. Never a dull moment. Boy, I'm having quite the day, what with meeting the princess and finding a long-lost uncle.
So, you've met the princess, eh? I heard you have ambition and intend to make a fortune, just like Arnold Schwarzenegger. Well, I'm always telling people I'm going to be rich someday, but... I mean, I mean it when I say it, but of course, where would I get the money from?
I could tell you.
You could?
Listen, boy, those bags of gold I gave your mother are but drops in the ocean, grains of sand on the seashore. I, your Uncle Abenazar, can lead you to riches beyond your wildest dreams.
If you wanna what change the situation, right people, right time, just the wrong location. Now
so good for me. Simple boy is ABC. There ain't nothing you can't go. I'll be so good for you.
You can be so good for me.
Simple boy is ABC.
I'll see it through to XYZ.
There ain't nothing you can't go through. I'll be so good for you.
Sometimes I feel just like a poor relation. To get the girl I love, I have to change my station. Take and shake it, it's a deal. Abenazer, I really feel I could be good for you.
You could be so good for me.
I'll be right by your side.
Every boy set me free.
There ain't nothing you can hide. I'll be so good for you.
You could be so good for us.
We're a team.
Through thick and thin and make no fuss.
I tell you nothing, body, nothing,
nothing we cannot do. I'll be so good for you. Don't ask me no questions. I'll tell you no lies. Use my wisdom to rest on. I will be right by your side. I will help you reach your goal.
I will be so good for you.
Help me shake that rock and roll.
Help you like you want me to.
I can make your dreams come true.
I'll be so good for you.
Help me move that rock and roll.
Let it roll, let it roll.
With a heart and soul.
That's right, baby.
Ooh, I'll be so good for you. I'll be so good for you. Good for you.
All right, I'll do it. I'll buy it. But what's the catch?
Catch?
Yeah.
There is no catch, boy. Pardon, dear nephew. I get carried away when I think of the great secret I hold, the power within my grasp.
The power?
To help you, my boy. There is no limit to the riches within your reach, if you will be guided by me and do my bidding.
All right, I'll do it. I mean, what have I got to lose, right, kids? Okay, I'll do it. I'll do whatever you want me to.
Tomorrow morning, leave the city by the Great Gate.
Great Gate.
Yes, take the path all the way up to Whistler.
Whistler.
Yes, past the Banff Springs Hotel.
Banff Springs
take
Hotel.
Take the fork in the road.
Fork in the road.
Ski across Saskatchewan.
Ski across
Saskatchewan. Swim across the Lake of the Woods.
Lake of the Woods.
Take the Gardiner Expressway to the CN Tower.
To the CN Tower.
Meet me there at dawn.
At dawn.
Meanwhile, not a word to a living soul.
Oh,
not
dear, oh, dear, oh, goodness gracious.
Mom, what's wrong?
The Emperor's guards are coming to our rescue. You better hide.
Oh. The Emperor's guards, you say?
Fear not. Leave this to me.
Oh, boys, I see you've come for the smalls.
All right, all right, all right.
Oh, dear, oh, dear.
Zakaba!
Well, that was some trick. What happened to them?
To save you, boy, I put them in a trance.
A trance? You mean nobody can move?
No.
This is what I've been waiting for.
Apollo will rise beyond the rim of yonder mountains. My hour of triumph approaches. But how do I get the boy into the cave? He's timid and an obvious coward. He's bound to be reluctant to enter. I need information!
You, robbed?
Tell me, O Barbara Eden, reasonable facsimile, Why can't I go into the cave to retrieve the lamp?
Only the one named Aladdin can enter the cave, so it is written.
No, you're not being very helpful, you know. Tell me, Scheherazade, how does it feel to be a slave?
It is cold within the ring.
I must keep my hands in my pockets more often.
Tis but a little thing.
I beg your pardon?
To be cold.
Oh, yes.
I beg you, master, release me from the ring and let me return to mortality.
Never! You shall remain within the ring, and when I'm master of the world, maybe I won't need you anymore. Be gone! Once I have the lamp, I shall dispense with our little storyteller once and for all. I'll banish her to Manitoba. I'll make a dance with the Royal Winnipeg Ballet in January. On the corner of Portage and Main. Yes. But how long must I wait? The boy said he'd be here before dawn.
Is Dawn here?
Not yet.
Oh, thank goodness I'm here before her.
Where have you been?
Oh, I'm sorry I was late, Uncle, but I just flew in from Prince George, and boy, my arms are killing me.
And you're booing me? Yeah, really?
You gave it to me.
Look! Look over here, boy! You see this great boulder?
Yes.
It conceals the entrance to a large cave, yeah, as old as time itself.
Well, I'm not too keen on big empty spaces.
Nonsense, boy. I tell you, there is something in that cave that I want, something only you can get for me.
You must be raving mad. Why can't you go in there and get it yourself?
Because I can't! Don't you see, dear boy, due to an old war wound, I'm not as agile as you. That old war wound was a perfectly placed toe shoe. Besides, you are younger than I and have better legs.
Pee-wee Herman has better legs than you.
Shut up! Any more funny remarks? I shall push you into that cave unprotected and let the skeletons tickle you to death.
Skeletons?
That's right, skeletons.
Bye.
Have you forgotten our bargain? Untold riches in exchange for a small service? I tell you, boy, there is something in that cave I must have!
What is it?
A lamp. Just an old lamp.
You mean to tell me you brought me out here at this time of the morning just for a silly old lamp?
That's right.
We've got one at home you could have. Besides, how am I supposed to get in there with that great boulder in the way?
I shall move the boulder by magic. Open sesame!
I don't believe you did that. I think it was just a cheap trick. A cheap trick? Yes.
A cheap trick? Do you know how insulting that is to me?
Insulting?
Insulting? To what? Listen, you poor man's Patrick Swayze.
Okay. You poor man's Julio Iglesias.
To all the girls I've loved before.
You musician? Hey, I wasn't talking to you. I said musician.
Oh, no. My turn. You husband of a ballerina.
Get in that cage.
Well, I don't know.
Get in there.
Uncle, I
Get
don't
in
like
that
the,
cave,
I don't
boy.
Like the,
He's in!
I'm out!
Get back in there!
No, it's dark.
Nonsense, boy. Look, boy. Look, take this magic ring. It will ward off evil spirits and protect you from harm.
The magic ring?
Yes.
Are you sure it works?
Of course I'm sure. In you go.
It'll help me inside?
Of course it will. In you go.
Well, I don't know.
Get in now!
I don't
get
know if
in,
I should
get in. Get in!
Wow!
He's in!
Aladdin and I have entered the cave to retrieve the lamp. That's me on his finger. I don't mind helping. I believe in giving people a hand when they deserve it.
He'll see.
We asked the world's greatest tea lovers to describe the superb taste of red rose tea in their own words.
It tastes fine. It's absolutely straddling the milk. And I think if I would jump
to the fire. Absolutely spiffy. I mean, it's so right.
Unfortunately, we had no idea what they were saying.
Yes.
Until we told them Red Rose's unique blend is only available in Canada.
Oh. Pizza?
From Walt Disney Pictures, he's the king of the sea. She's his evil enemy. And they're in a fight to the finish.
Have you lost your senses?
He's trying to save his daughter, the Little Mermaid.
Daddy, look out!
From her evil grasp.
She's mine now.
Ursula, stop!
Now it'll take all of his courage.
So be it.
And everything in his power to win the battle. Only in theaters, it's Walt Disney Pictures' The Little Mermaid.
Starts Friday at a theater near you.
We've got a cottage.
So every weekend we're loading up a lot of stuff, plus the kids and the dog. So we need something to take all that. And rough roads too. I don't know, I'm not really a station wagon kind of guy.
At Passport, we know what you really want. The Isuzu Trooper, the four-door 4x4 for under $23,000.
Last Christmas, I heard a noise, and I went downstairs, and there he was, you know who, coming out of the fireplace. And unfortunately, he singed himself, and he was running around going, hoo, hoo, ha, ha, ha. So I grabbed for my camera, and darn, I was out of film. Thankfully, my sketch pad was nearby, but you know, it's just not the same. This year, I'm stocking up with Black's great new film. You buy three, you get one free. You can't miss.
Black's is photography.
Give a child a good book and watch imagination grow. That's why Mr. Christie proudly announces the first Mr. Christie's Book Awards. A total of $30,000 in awards to the creators of the best Canadian children's books each year. Mr. Christie has always helped feed little tummies. Now he would also like to help feed little minds.
Sears Happy Holiday Sale comes together beautifully with men's coordinates. Start with sports shirts at $12.99 and $14.99. Then add sweaters at $14.99 and $19.99. Wrap up your best wishes at Sears.
People write me for advice on all kinds of grooming problems. Some want to know how to remove unsightly nose and ear hair. I tell them about the Remington Hygienic Clipper. It removes hair safely and precisely. Quality grooming product from Remington.
Of all the Emperor's treasures, none surpass the song of the nightingale. Until one day...
Take her away.
Distracted by a new gift, the Emperor almost forgets what he truly values in life. The Nightingale, a CTV special Friday for the child in all of us.
Yes, I'm here. No thanks to you.
Can you see anything?
Only stars. I think I banged my head.
Never mind your head. Can you see the lamp?
Oh, you and your silly old lamp, Uncle. It's very dark in here. How am I supposed to find anything without a light? Look. The lamp. I found the lamp.
Give it to me at once!
But it's all dirty and beaten up. It can't be worth much.
Give me the lamp, you son of a she-camel.
Don't be rude about my mom.
I want that lamp!
You can yell all you like, Uncle, but you're not getting this lamp.
Then heed my words and heed them well. I swear this tale you'll never tell. You'll have no air to fuel your moans, nor have the sun to bleach your bones. Abracadabra! Abracadee. I bid you close now. Sesame!
Uncle, don't leave me, please. Here, you can have your lamp. I'm shut in. I'm shut in forever. I'll never see my mom or the princess ever again. What am I going to do? How am I going to get out of here? The ring. He said it would protect me. The ring. But how? Wait a minute. There's a face in the ring. It's moving. It's the face of a beautiful woman. What?
Your wish is my command, O master.
Who are you?
I am Scheherazade. I was imprisoned by Abenazza within the ring, but now you possess the jewel just as I planned.
You mean you planned all this?
Oh, yes. I allowed Abenazza to take over the story and fooled him into believing that he was in control. I played upon his vanity and his lust for power.
Can you get us out of here?
Oh, no. That I cannot do. I do not have the power.
So we're stuck here forever?
No, Aladdin. You have the power in your hand.
The lamp? It's just a dirty old lamp.
It is the most fabulous object in the entire universe.
In what way?
Rub the lamp, Aladdin. Rub the lamp.
The slave of the lamp appears at your command, O master.
Bookends.
Welcome, slave, to the cave of a thousand sighs.
Scheherazade, thank goodness you're safe. I thought we were lost forever.
You were safe within the lamp, sire. The vizier plans to take your throne, and once he possesses the lamp, to rule the world.
Then you planned all this?
Yes.
What an imagination.
Excuse me, but could somebody please tell me what's going on?
Aladdin, this is the slave of the lamp. He can grant any wish your heart desires.
Can he get us out of here?
Oh, yes, that he can. But first, there are wonders in this cave that no man has laid eyes upon in 1,000 years.
Well, what sort of wonders?
Long before Pekin was a city, the great genie of Babylon stole the treasure of Solomon and hid it in this cave. Here it has lain for 1,000 years, waiting for its new owner.
Who is that?
Why, you, Aladdin. You are now the richest man in the world.
Me? You mean all the treasure hidden here in the cave, it's mine?
Yours and what? Yours alone.
Well, where is it?
All around you, Aladdin. All you have to do is command, and it will appear.
Command, and it will appear.
In the name of the great Aladdin, I command the treasure of King Solomon to appear!
Life is unfolding as it should. I got to dance, Aladdin got all the treasure, tax-free, and everybody's happy. Well, maybe not everybody.
To enjoy again and again the exquisite taste of meat cooked on the grill, try the T-Fell Nonstick Steak Pan. Designed for even heat distribution and quick frying of meat, the T-Fell Steak Pan is ideal for low-calorie cooking thanks to its deep grooves. They allow for maximum draining of excess oil and grease. Don't hesitate to try all your favorite dishes in this cast aluminum nonstick fry pan because it's so easy to clean. The T-Fell Nonstick Steak Pan cooks a really good steak. Another tasty idea from T-Fell.
What's this then?
Ragu, a real Italian meal needs a real Italian-style spaghetti sauce.
That was
really rather good. How about an early night then?
Ragu, it brings out the Italian in you.
It's two for the show. The hottest tickets in town from Sears. Imagine, you get two movie passes to Cineplex Odeon, two soft drinks, and don't forget two popcorns, all for just $6. Two for the show. A great gift found only at Sears.
Shop in a store that looks like this, and you know exactly how you're going to be treated. Same goes when you shop in a store like this. But imagine how well you're going to be treated in a store that looks like this. Nice store. Nice people. Nice treatment. That's something we don't get enough of these days. And it's one of the advantages of dealing with number one. Nice. Like me.
It's two for the show. The hottest tickets in town from Sears. Imagine, you get two movie passes to Cineplex Odeon, two soft drinks, and don't forget two popcorns, all for just $6. Two for the show. A great gift found only at Sears.
Such a lot to tell you, Mom. We don't have to take in washing anymore.
Well, I suppose you've won the lottery?
No. I'm a prince now. I am the richest man in the world. I've got a magic ring and a magic lamp that'll grant me any wish that I desire.
He's been at the Harvey Wallbangers again.
Where did he get those magnificent clothes from, you thief?
Come on now, own up, or it's the Chinese water torture for you.
You take your hands off my boy. He may be a scoundrel and a cheat, a liar and a thief, but that's no reason for bad manners.
You're quite right, madam. We were forgetting our position.
Oh, I wasn't. You were standing right here, and I was just over
there. I mean, we are guardians of the law. We should set an example. I shall approach this dilemma in the time-honored way of all law enforcement officers the world over. As upholders of the peace and servants of the public, there is, of course, a perfectly simple way to deal with this.
Good.
Hey! Ow. After you!
The slave of the lamp appears at your command, O master.
Static cling.
No, Mom, that's the slave of the lamp, and he's my slave now. Everything I told you is true.
You mean we're rich?
We're rich.
You're a prince?
I'm a prince.
And I'm a queen.
Well, you said it.
In that case, I shouldn't be standing around here in public in these rags. I'd better rush down to the shops, find some haute couture better suited for my new station in life. If anybody comes looking for me, I'll be in the evening wear department at Honest Ed's warehouse. Beam me up, Scotty.
Are we to understand that you are now the richest man in the world?
You are.
And are we also to understand that you came by these riches legitimate, limited, without pinching them?
You are.
And is it safe to assume that you are now richer than the Emperor?
It is.
Fellas, wait a minute.
It's okay. I forgive you. You were only doing your jobs. Hey, how would you like to work for me now?
Us? Work for you?
Why not? Grab your coat and get your hat. Leave your worries on the doorstep. Just direct your feet to the sunny side of the street. Catch a hit, that hit up, and a happy tune is your step. Life can be so sweet on the sunny side of the street. I used to walk in the shade with the blues on parade. Now I'm not afraid of this rover crossed over. And if I never had a cent, I'd be rich as Rockefeller. Gold dust at my feet on the sunny side of the street. Gentlemen, up to this point in the evening, I think you've gotten entirely the wrong impression of me. I really believe that. And just to show you that beneath this gruff exterior beats a heart of pure goodness, I want to sing for you one of my all-time favorite Christmas carols. And I hope it shall be one of yours, too. Fen, please.
Children roasting on an open fire.
Yes! Yes! Oh, I love it! Feeling charitable and concerned for my stricken nephew, I return to the cave to release the brat and maybe retrieve the lamp. But what do I find? Nothing. Nada. Rien. The boy gone, the lamp obviously still in his possession, and the cave stripped of its original splendor. But what to do? What to do? The boy has discovered the lamp's power and escaped. But he won't be able to keep a secret for long. He's a braggart and is bound to tell someone.
Direct your feet. To the expensive side of the street.
Oh, look, Tammy Faye Baker. Madam.
Not since I took up washing.
Tell me, oh beauteous one, how fares my beloved nephew since we last met?
Well, my son is now a prince of the blood.
Really? And you?
I am a duchess of the Guinness.
This is amazing. How came you by this good fortune, oh creature of the gods?
You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
Try me.
Well, I think it had something to do with finding a bucket in a cave, or was it a teapot? Might have been a beer mug. No, I'm sure it was a bucket.
Could it be by some strange coincidence, a lamp?
Well, yes. Yes, I believe it was. Tacky little thing like something you'd find in a shopper's drug mart.
Where is his lamp now?
Well, Aladdin takes it with him wherever he goes. He's on his way to the Emperor's palace right now. We've both been invited to take tea in his chambers. Personally, I'd rather have it in a teacup, but you can't quibble with royalty.
This is great news indeed, oh former hairy-chested one. Tell me, may I accompany you?
No, you may not. I believe that success is relative, and the more success you have, the more relative you find you've got.
Are you accusing me of being on the make?
Yes.
Well, I've never been so insulted in all my life.
You ought to get out more often.
Well, I never did.
Go on, you must have done.
You do not realize, madam, to whom you are talking to.
Oh, push off, have a banana. You're not Aladdin's uncle. And you're not my long-lost husband's long-lost brother either. You're just a gold-digging, social-climbing gigolo.
Oh. You don't even know what gigolo means.
Oh, yes, they do.
Why? How dare you, you ugly old bat?
Well, ugly I may be, but I'll have you know that I've got the body of a young girl.
Well, give it back. You're making it all wrinkled. So, Aladdin has discovered the secret of the lamp, but is probably too stupid to realize its potential. I must get into the Emperor's palace, but how? Force is out of the question. I hate the sight of blood, especially my own. A disguise. Yes. What is it? Yes, that's it. I have it! I shall disguise myself as one of the most feared and despised creatures on God's earth. A musician!
Our story becomes mysterious as Abenazer puts on a strange disguise, only to learn from the lovely Dolores that the blondes with the big hankies are the ones who have more fun.
With a talent for brightening up the holidays, McDonald's has something special just for you. For a short time, we're serving holiday chicken McNuggets with a festive orange sauce. There are also thick, rich eggnog milkshakes and cool peppermint sundaes. They're just our way of brightening up the season.
And you can brighten up someone else's holiday with McDonald's gift certificates, a great gift for anyone on your list.
What's happened to Cliff?
You have turned this man into an invalid.
Has he lost control? Could it be the return of Denise?
Hey, you guys, I'm married!
Or is it Denise's daughter?
It's too short. You have a job? Then I guess I can't get any money out of you.
Have Cliff and Claire had enough?
Are we going to come back home?
Yes, after Rudy's graduated from college.
The Cosby Show, Thursday nights on CTV.
Give her time to remember how it feels to be tender and to shake her world of weariness.
New General Foods International Coffee's Cafe Peach Cream Flavor Instant Coffee Mix.
With a cup of tenderness.
Don't you hate this? Dishes straight from the dishwasher with hard bits of food stuck to them. That's because the heat actually cooks the food on. Watch. Macaroni and cheese in a sealed dish. It's going to cook and stick. See? Cooked hard, stuck hard. Now the good news. Dishwasher All has been improved to deal with this. Scrape out that mess, load up the machine. Now add the new All. Those granules contain heat-activated cleaners. They make the heat work for you, not against you. Shining clean. New Dishwasher All with heat-activated cleaners. Don't get stuck with anything less.
It's two for the show. The hottest tickets in town from Sears. Imagine, you get two movie passes to Cineplex Odeon, two soft drinks, and don't forget two popcorns, all for just $6. Two for the show. A great gift found only at Sears.
In the town. Yes, I can cook too. My fish can't be beat. My sugar's the sweetest around. I'm a man's ideal of a perfect meal, right down to the deadbeat tag. I'm a pot of joy for a hungry boy, baby. I'm cooking with gas, so I'm a gumdrop, a sweet lollipop, a brook trout right out of a brook.
Do something about your dentures. Okay, let me have it.
I have arranged a marriage for you this day to a most favorable dynasty.
Oh, not the Colbys.
No, no, no. This one is far greater, far richer.
It goes by the unusual name of Twanky, and the suitor in question is entitled the Prince Aladdin.
Aladdin? Hmm, sounds familiar.
It would be a most favorable match, daughter. I'm most concerned about rising inflation.
What's this prince like? Is he handsome?
He is a frightfully rich merchant prince.
Well, then bring him in. We'll get hitched right away.
I knew you'd see the light. Bring the Prince Aladdin to me at once. There is only one problem, what you might call a very fat fly in the ointment.
Oh, I knew there'd be a catch.
He has a mother.
Well, so?
But this is no run-of-the-mill mother. The way she dresses, it may be Flora McDonald trying to make a comeback.
His Highness, Prince Aladdin.
Your Majesty, welcome to our Imperial Palace, Prince. There is someone here most eager to meet you.
Hiya, Toots.
Hey, it's you, the kid from the apple tree.
The Prince of the apple tree. The Prince of the garbage bin. The
Young
Prince
man,
of
the familiarity of your greeting is most unwelcome.
It's an old custom where I come from, Your Majesty.
And where do you come from?
Oh, a great and powerful kingdom called the gutter.
I've heard of it.
Yes.
The Dowager Duchess of Twang Ki.
Hiya, Tots!
Oh, well, I think I'm gonna like it here. Well, no, MP, let's get down to business. You've got a daughter and I've got a son. Get it?
Got it.
Good.
It would seem a most suitable match, my dear Duchess. I take it you'll require a dowry.
Oh, no, just a rub down with a hot towel and a change of earrings.
How about fixing a date for the nuptial?
Well, shouldn't you speak to your empress first?
There is no empress, though. I am a widower.
Oh, you poor thing. All alone in this world with nobody to butter up his hot crumpets. Well, now, Impy, I've heard it rumored that you've got over 200 porcupines.
You mean concubines?
Do I?
Yes, concubines are very beautiful girls. Porcupines are little animals with very sharp spikes. A lot of people make that mistake.
I bet they don't make that mistake twice.
They shall be married at once. Let the ceremony commence. Okay, kiss bride.
Now, is that all there is to it?
It is.
Really? Dearly beloved, you may kiss the bride. If I'd known it was this easy, I'd have bagged him in Act One.
This is a most happy day. We must have entertainment.
Your Majesty! Your Majesty! Your Majesty! Your Majesty, there is a strolling player without. He craves an audience.
He can have this one.
He wishes to perform for your magnificence. Spare no expense. Send him in.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your delight and delectation.
That master of prestidigitation and sleight of hand.
A smile, a song, and a flight of doves.
All the way from Caesar's Palace, Moose Jaw,
the great Twerple.
It gives me great pleasure to introduce to you my assistant, Dolores, a recent graduate from the National Ballet School. Dolores!
Mm-hmm.
feature the amazing talents of my beautiful assistant, Dolores. She has the body of a Dolly Parton, the face of an angel, and the mind of an Albert Einstein. Mind reading, ladies and gentlemen, is her particular talent, and this we will demonstrate for you now. Will you blindfold Dolores, please? Can you see anything, Dolores?
No.
Oh, ladies and gentlemen, the next part of my act requires that I come down and be with you in the audience. I wonder, sir, if I could borrow a little something that I can show Dolores. Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, and Dolores.
Yes?
I hold in my hand the first object of our experiment. Can you tell me what it is? Quickly, my dear, we haven't much time.
It's a wristwatch.
Correct. That's wonderful, ladies and gentlemen. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Dolores, will you kindly go behind the screen now, please?
I'm going behind the screen.
She's going behind the screen. Behind the screen now, Dolores.
I'm behind the screen.
She's behind the screen now. Ladies and gentlemen, I hold in my hand an ordinary telephone book from A to B. I open the book at random, and I wonder, madam, could you choose a name from either the top or the bottom of any of these columns on this page? Sure you can, madam. Thank you. How about that name right there? Okay, that's a good name. Dolores is page 180.
Yes?
It's the first name at the top of the first column. Quickly, my dear.
It's Mrs. Katie Braun.
Is that right, madam? Fantastic, ladies and gentlemen. It's incredible, isn't it? It's real scary, actually, huh? Just to further delight you, ladies and gentlemen, at random, I will open the page to 440, and sir, kindly choose a name from either the top or the bottom of this page. Thank you, sir. Dolores, page 440, the bottom name of the second column. Quickly, dear, read my mind. What's the matter, Dolores?
Somebody's torn the page out.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. The next part of my act requires the assistance of a beautiful girl. I would choose Dolores, but I would only be accused of trickery. And I assure you, the next part of my act is pure magic.
Oh, well, I'll do it, then I'll do it!
Ladies and gentlemen, we do have a volunteer.
Princess, I don't think you should.
Oh, don't be such a party pooper, Princey Poo. What do I have to do, Tricky Dicky?
Well, step right into the box, Princess, and all will be revealed.
Well, it's kind of dark in there. Do you think if I just...
Then you shall require a lamp!
So shy, go get me that old lamp of Aladdin, too.
No, wait a minute, you can't use that one.
Why not?
Why not, Aladdin?
Well, that's my special lamp. Well,
I could just borrow it.
Be very, very careful with it.
Oh, sure, just don't make such a fuss about an old lamp. Okay, Jesus is excited.
Into the box, Princess. She's in, she's in. Ladies and gentlemen, I shall now require complete silence and concentration, please. Into the box, I place the girl. Now sands of time begin to swirl. Poor Prince Aladdin, don't feel bad. Your wife is safe in far Baghdad!
Princess! Princess! She's gone. This is serious. We've been tricked. Is that right, kids?
Yeah!
We've been tricked!
I hold you personally responsible for the safety of my daughter, Prince!
Yeah, but that's not fair, beloved. It's not Aladdin's fault.
Aladdin, that change of a name is a familiar to me. You are the young Corimino that caused such mayhem in the city. I knew there was some... And you are the Heridon Gorgon that accosted me in the street and looked upon our imperial face without permission.
But that's all in the past, Grumpy. We're married now, remember?
Now we are divorced.
Jeez, things happen quick around here.
We resign.
We hand in our notice.
We no longer work for you. You are persona non grata.
Well, what does that mean?
It means back to soaking socks, dear.
Oh, no. I can't let all that I've worked for slip through my fingers like this. There must be a way. There must be someone else who can help me. The ring. I've forgotten all about the ring.
Your wish is my command, O master.
Jeannie, the princess has been kidnapped along with the lamp.
Yes, I know.
Well, what can we do?
We can travel forward through time itself, Aladdin. We can travel forward exactly 1,000 years to the city of Baghdad.
But how can we do that?
Back through the realms of imagination from whence we came.
You mean to reality?
Exactly.
But this is a pantomime. We belong here.
The lamp is as powerful in reality as it is here, Aladdin. We cannot allow Abenazar to change the world. There would be no music.
No splendor.
No laughter.
No chases.
No love.
Quickly, we have no time to lose. To Baghdad.
As usual, it takes a woman to bring the men back to reality. But Abenazar has the princess and the lamp, and we've got to get there before he rubs either one of them.
This year, you can bring someone special home for Christmas. McDonald's presents Muppet Babies. Baby Kermit, Baby Fozzie Bear, and Baby Miss Piggy. A different one every week while supplies last. $2.69 each, and with every purchase, you're donating 50 cents to Ronald McDonald Children's Charities. Muppet Baby plush toys for a limited time at participating McDonald's.
Good time, great taste of McDonald's.
Victor Kaya.
Hi.
What's a great shaving gift?
The Remington Microscreen. It's two flexible screens shave as close as the blade or your money back. No other shaver makes that promise.
Perfect. Maybe my husband will buy the company.
The Remington Microscreen.
On March 31st, Rob Boyd will ski Whistler for money. Maybe your money. In the Fuji Downhill Dash for Cash. There's $1 million in cash and prizes, including a Saab 900 Sport. See what Rob Boyd can grab for you in the Fuji Downhill Dash for Cash.
It's going to be a lot easier on snow.
Get details wherever you buy Fuji film or Fuji cameras.
Grab the excitement!
In your lifetime, this happens so rarely. This, however, will happen just once. Toyota's 25th anniversary in Canada. And in celebration, the limited edition Corolla, Camry, and Tercel. Distinctive, specially equipped, built in very limited numbers. And like the Eclipse, here, then gone.
You're growing up, and I wish you could stay. You're growing up, more a man each day.
I only give Jimmy Kraft single slices. Each slice contains 7 ounces of milk, and only 2 slices are an excellent source of calcium to help Jimmy's bones and teeth grow.
You're growing up right before my eyes.
Kraft singles, good food to grow up on.
Mmm, what's that fragrance you're wearing?
What's the ultimate shaving gift?
The Remington Microscreen Ultimate. It's 2 screens shave as close as a blade or your money back. No other shaver makes that promise.
Now I know why he bought the company.
Remington.
The most
most fabulous object in the entire universe belongs to me.
Listen, baboon breath. This is getting tedious. Let's get back to the palace gardens.
You are far from your father's gardens, my pets. You shall remain here and be my queen and rule over the entire world with me.
Don't you realize I'm just a figment of your imagination? I belong in the story, not here in your tacky little world.
Then you shall add some fantasy to this dull existence, for you shall be mine. Imagination or no imagination.
No, never.
Perhaps a little friendly persuasion in the dungeons will help. Igor!
He screamed, master.
Take the princess to the dungeons. Place her in the Dracula suite. Maybe she'd like to do a little necking.
Oh, for heaven's sakes. Lead on, Igor. We'll check out this suite.
I can't believe my good fortune. Everything I've worked for is now mine. I have the kingdom. The caliph is my slave. I have the princess and the lamb.
That's what you think, Uncle. You forgot one thing. You thought you were safe, but I still have the ring.
Scheherazade!
That's right, Scheherazade!
Precisely, Vizier. Scheherazade!
You won't get away with this. The caliph is no longer here to protect you. I am the power in this kingdom.
That's where you're wrong, Vizier. Beggar, rub the lamp.
No!
Where am I? What's happened?
You are back safe in Baghdad, Your Majesty.
That it was all a dream?
It was a story.
And what a story. But you, Vizier, I have a recollection of you behaving quite extraordinarily. You called me a miserable little monarch.
And so you are! You shall not thwart me now! Any of you! Now who has the power? I am the lamp!
No one has the power of the lamp. It is but a figment of all our imagination.
No. No. I held it in my hand, and now it's gone.
And so shall you be, Vizier. I strip you of all titles and privileges and banish you from this land until my pleasure decrees you forgiven.
You know, I can see right up your nose from here. She made me do it. She's a witch.
She is to be my wife, the queen. She will rule this land with me till the end of our days. And you're going to change, Vizier. You will be good.
You'll never be good. I hate you. I hate that silly little hat and the silly little feathers. I hate this audience. I hate those lights. I hate those television cameras! I especially hate that little boy! And I really hate...
love genies! Oh, look! Kitty Winky! I love Kitty Winky!
Scheherazade, we're to be married on the morrow. I'm the happiest man alive.
Excuse me, but what is to become of me?
That is a problem. What shall we do with him, my beloved?
He is clever, sire.
That's true.
He is crafty, too.
That's very true.
Well?
Of course. You shall be my new vizier. Have all the titles, lands, and privileges he's forfeit. What is it, boy? You have everything a man could want.
Was the princess a figment of my imagination?
I'm afraid she was.
Well, then I wish for nothing. I'm no better now than when I first entered your palace.
Do you love her?
Very much.
Love is a very powerful thing.
More powerful than the lamp?
Oh, much more powerful. You can be with her whenever you wish, you know.
But how?
Just by closing your eyes and imagining that she is here.
Just by... closing my eyes.
Just by closing your eyes.
I wish my princess were here with me now. I wish my princess were here with me now. I wish my princess were here with me now.
Aladdin?
Princess. You're here.
Yeah, I got bored bouncing Igor against the wall.
But I thought you were... I thought I'd never see you again.
Oh, yeah, I was beginning to think the same thing.
I love you.
Oh, you don't.
I do.
No, you don't.
I do.
You do? Well... Imagine that.
Our story is over, but we're putting on especially beautiful costumes to say goodbye in. And when you see Widow Twanky, you'll want to say goodbye.
It's two for the show, the hottest tickets in town from Sears. Imagine, you get two movie passes to Cineplex Odeon, two soft drinks, and don't forget two popcorns, all for just $6. Two for the show, a great gift found only at Sears.
I'll be home for Christmas. You can plan on me. Please have snow and mistletoe.
Home Hardware has the perfect Christmas gift. This year, the Proctor Silex 12-cup coffee maker is $49.99. Toaster oven, $69.99. Come home for Christmas. Home Hardware.
Look what's cooking from Corningware. Beautiful patterns for your microwave. There's peach floral.
Lovely.
French white.
Classy.
Shadow iris.
Stunning.
Beautiful patterns from Corningware. It's a different look to cooking.
Love it.
With time, nature robs all living things of moisture. But Vaseline Intensive Care Lotion can restore it. It works on contact, replacing your skin's lost moisture. And if it can restore something as dry as this leaf, imagine what it can do for your hands. Vaseline Intensive Care Lotion.
In the spirit of the season, CTV is pleased to present a true holiday classic, Scrooge, in its all-new colorized version.
I wish to be left alone.
Alistair Sim is Ebenezer Scrooge.
You will be visited by three spirits.
I'm too old. I'm beyond hope.
Based on Charles Dickens' A Christmas Carol, this 1951 film classic captures the true meaning of Christmas. Scrooge, next on CTV. Brought to you in part by Canadian Tire.
The time to buy one of Canada's best-selling trucks has never been better. That's because it's Wheel and Deal Month at GM. And right now, your BC GM dealer is featuring more models with more selections in more styles than ever before. We've got the wheels, you get the deals on everything from compact vans to full-size pickups. Cruise into your local GM dealer for the Wheel and Deal extravaganza and drive home your deal today.
R-E-S-P-E-C-T from the GM dealers of BC.
Remember life before the cordless phone and the telephone answerer? Right now, get a Radio Shack TAD 1000 phone answerer for only $89.95 and a dual phone cordless phone for $79.95.
Come touch technology from Radio Shack.
Thank you.
Tomorrow night, put on your thinking caps and let your imagination run wild by joining in a fun-filled celebration, the Teddy Bears Picnic, a CTV special for the child in all of us.
Now, stay here for Scrooge, starring Alistair Sim. It's coming up next on BCTV. Alistair Sim stars in the timeless story of the real meaning of Christmas, this time with a twist, Scrooge in color. 9 tonight on BCTV.
Why choose a Starford Magic Can? You seem to have tried everything.
Oh, it's magic. It works all the time and on all shapes of cans. Left or right-handed without slipping. And above all, I don't have to touch the lids anymore.
Magic Can, it works like magic. Why choose a Starford Magic Twist?
Oh, it's magic. It works all the time on all sorts of jars and bottles with a twist of the wrist. No adjustments, no effort. And above all, I don't need Sam anymore.
Starford Magic Twist. It works.
How you doing? I'm Rudolph for Mark's Work Warehouse. My years with Santa taught me a lot about Christmas gifts. Our delivery trips used to be chilly. Now there's Mountain Gear Solar Fleece from Mark's Work Warehouse. Perfect outerwear for any season. Warm and cozy. Rainbow of colors and styles for the whole family. Starting at just $39.99. Take it from me and the boss. It's a guarantee that Mark's Work Warehouse has Christmas gifting all wrapped up.
Tonight, the story of the true Christmas spirit comes to life. In color. A CTV special presentation.
Save myself from what?
Based on Charles Dickens' immortal classic.
It could only be on Christmas Day that I would drink the health of such a hard, stingy, unfeeling man as Mr. Scrooge. You know he is, Robert. Nobody knows it better than you do, poor fellow.
A story of redemption.
I am the spirit of Christmas present.
A fantasy that'll fill your heart.
The shadows of things that must be.
It's about the deepest feeling of the human soul.
God bless everyone.
Do you believe in me or not?
It's about orphans of a forgotten world.
I am the ghost of Christmas past.
It's about the secret to everlasting life.
But we have not done yet, Ebenezer Scrooge.
Whose funeral were they talking about?
Scrooge, a very special Christmas presentation, next. This special holiday presentation is brought to you in part by Canadian Tire, where you can give like Santa and save.